Hello friends, my name is Lunernight, and welcome to a game called Remnant from the Ashes. This game is made by Perfect World and I don't remember the other one. But it's looks like it's pretty similar to like Dark Souls. It's got like a Dark Souls-ish kind of feel. And I just realized I have no idea if you can actually see me. Hi. So yeah. We're gonna click this button and get started. Like oh, Jesus, fuck. Once. You know what? I know that I should make a silly character, but I want to make What's a cool doing character. Here? Wait, no, she cute. Go back. It's pale ass chick. I wonder what happens if I randomize.
Hey, this could be useful.
Indeed, she's cute.
I wonder what this is.
They're all so cute. I don't really want to make an old lady because, like, I don't know, I just don't want to play an old lady. No offense to the old people out there. I'm going to play this generic white girl. Holy hell, that hair. Do they have one that's like my hairstyle right now? I don't think they do. So what is that? That's a ponytail. Normally I'd go for the ponytail. This one's kind of similar to mine. I got the red, I got the bluish green. Okay. Here, let's just make me. Hell as fuck. I really like the scars though. I'm probably gonna give her a really cool looking scar. Poor girl. I'm sorry I have to do this to you. That one's almost like the one I have on my lip, except for I don't have one on my chin. Hey, look! It's the one that I have on my lip. This is perfect. Holy shit, it's just me.
What's this doing here?
I think I'm gonna go with voice too.
I wonder what this is.
Yep. Okay. This is my chick. She kind of sort of looks like me. I really wish I could give her blue hair, but you know what? It's fine. Yeah. It's just me. I don't even know how to play this game. Friends only? Offline? Sure. I don't have a save. Is that important? Excuse me while I turn this down a little. It's raining outside, so it's not like super bright. Oh.
What can we do when our last hope fails? That you must discover.
This is me in like 10 years.
Sail the sea before you, in search of an end to the beasts that have hunted us for generations. Or so we thought, when the dragon rose into the sky like a phoenix, blazing in flames of agony. But our hero never came home. Only the storm, the beasts, the unshakable dread that something had twisted and turned. Your journey will not be easy. Storm swirls round the dragon's tower like a shroud. The dragon may be dead, but in its ashes, I fear something else is wrong. You will fight for every step. You must reach the tower, learn what became of our war. Face what lurks within.
I bet this looks super pretty with ultra graphics, but my computer can't handle that. I'm not gonna make it try. I'd rather get a nice video recorded.
Fails, another shall take its place. So long as we have breath.
What a way to go. LB to do a melee, hold to perform a charged melee. Okay. And yes, I am doing this on a mouse and keyboard. I didn't feel like hooking up my controller. It's all the way over there, and I'm lazy. It's my mouse. Has the game taken over my mouse? It looks like it has. Uh-oh. Coding overload. Hold on. I'll fix it. Okay, I think I got everything fixed. We're gonna find out. I changed the priority, so there might be a little bit of lagging. I'm sorry about that. Next time I play this, I'll do it on a different computer, but I don't have time to sit and wait for it to load at the moment. Press Alt to crouch. Okay. What's my Alt button? Oh god, that's gonna be annoying. I guess I don't really need to crouch and jump at the same time, though, so it's fine. Oof. Okay, this isn't gonna work at all. Yeah, okay. There's really nothing I can do to fix it. It's just gonna have to lag. I've already tried changing the settings. Everything is low, disabled, blah blah blah. I don't know what shadow distance means. So I can turn that down. That might help. Yeah. I don't know if that helped or not. Okay. Do a melee attack. Break these. Okay. Cool. Ooh. Bloodwort. Consumables offer temporary aid. They can be found in the world or purchased from merchants. Consumables will automatically be equipped once picked up, and there are no other consumables in the inventory. Press 1 to use equipped consumable. Okay. Why would I do that, though? I don't need it. Item to restore health. Oh, I guess I need a little bit of health back. Because my health bar is only half. Can I break this? Nope. Can I break these? Nope. Oh, I have a sword. Where the fuck am I in this, like, post-apocalyptic world? Hello? What the hell? Sorry, Mr. Plant Animal Dude. You were trying to kill me, I assume. So, my bad, homie. Dropping and dodging and sprinting depletes your stamina. Holy fuckballs. Hey. Excuse me, I dodged. Oh, it looks like I didn't actually get hit. Cool, do you guys drop things? No? Oh god, okay. Lovely. I was not expecting a horror game. Is something gonna come through this door? No? There's shit down there. Okay. Are you gonna teach me how to sneak? Oh, I tried. Ow, rude. What does right button do? No idea. Ooh, that really makes my game freak out. Okay, I'm guessing I have to go that way. Hello. Oh shit. Okay. Okay, this game doesn't like this at all. Oh, I've lost some health. Okay. How do I... Oh, I don't have any healing. What is that noise? Hello? Guessing it's coming from up there, but I want to see what's over here in this bus. Can I get on the bus? No? Hello? I guess not. Can I... Ah, shift to sprint. Die. Whoa. was just rude, buddy. Rude. Behind me is there. No. Something's going on over here. Can I go this way? No? Okay. Sorry about the lag. My computer doesn't like me very much sometimes. I totally just whacked the hell out of my microphone. Hello? Whoa. Cutscene. Can you go help him? You can take out like four of these, it's like no problem. He's out of ammo. Please go help him. Oh fuck, well he's dead. Go help him. Thank you, Christ. Oh, nope, he's very dead. He's gonna die. Yep, dude's dead. He tried. Just didn't try soon enough. Behind you? Time for some revenge. That's a lot. What the fuck are you? You died. Just that simple.
Hang in there.
Hurry
up, be okay.
We got company.
Hello, Ellen.
Move.
I have no idea what is going on, but that's okay. Ooh. Hello, you're a child.
Hi there.
Hello.
Whoa, take it slow. You got hurt real bad. You don't want to start bleeding again, do you?
Who are you?
Oh. I'm Wallace.
Nice to meet you.
I wanted to see you. I asked the commander if I could.
How did I get here?
Commander Ford and Mr. Riggler found you outside. They brought you here.
Riggler.
But they said... They said Mark... wasn't coming back. But he's... was... never mind.
Aw.
The commander said you should come see her when you woke up. She's in the room down the hall.
Okay.
She'll find a place for you. Everyone's got a place. I'll see you later.
Bye! You're adorable. Can I pick up items in here? There's a couple of beds, I'm guessing for four players. What's this? December 1968, Lieutenant Evelyn Sealer? Cooler? One of the only seven survivors to make it out of the atoll. We had to abandon Ward 16 and retreat to Central here in Ward 13. Everyone else, they're all dead. Harsgaard, Neville, Green, Parker, McKenzie, every last one of them is gone. We're the only ones left. The Root invaded Ward 13, too. There are bodies everywhere. Root and... you have both. Thankfully, the Root left for some reason. This place is abandoned. The Dreamers are gone. That is what the Root came for. I don't know how I know that, but I'm certain of it. The Root and the Dreamers are connected somehow. I can feel it. When the Dreamers were killed, the Root no longer had a reason to stay. Captain Ford, commander now, I guess, says we're holding up here while we figure out our next move. He's fixed the crystal so nothing can follow us from the atoll, and there's only a few physical entrances. It should be defensible for as long as we need it. God, this is a hell of a Hanukkah. April 15th of April, 1969. It's been months now. The ward almost feels normal. We clean the bodies out, though there are some doors we still can't get into. Commander Ford has us looking for survivors, getting them into the ward. He's a brave man. Smart. Not like the bastards who got us into this mess. Thanks to Ford, we survived that first wave of the Root invasion, which is more than could be said for the rest of the world. The Root didn't just come out of the wards. They attacked all over all at once. No one was ready. Armies were overwhelmed. France even tried nukes. Nukes on their own land. Then they went quiet. We've lost all communication with everyone. The city's a war zone. We're surviving, but barely. How long can we do this? May 1969. I've been having dreams lately. I hear the Root, smell them, watch them from inside their own heads as they hunt down and slaughter the survivors. When I wake up, I can still feel their joy, their rage. Sometimes it takes me a while to remember who I am, where I am. It's freaking me out. 24th of May, 1969. We lost so many people today. Took control of a water tower, though. It'll keep us alive, but I keep wondering if it's worth it. So many died so that we can, scrape by until they kill us, too? Commander Ford spoke for the dead, assured us that their sacrifices would not be forgotten. So long as we have breath, he said, we have hope. I wish I could believe that. 2nd of June, 1969. Ran across some old letters and journals from the folks who lived here before. They were full of hope, excitement. Andrew, Commander Ford, caught me reading. But I guess he's been reading them too. He said their hope worried him. It was misguided, he said, just like we were in Ward 16, just like I am now. I couldn't help but snort. What the hell did we have to be hopeful for? He laughed when I told him. He actually thinks we'll survive, that we'll come back from this somehow. I thought he was naive, but his hope is what kept us going, isn't it? It's kept us alive so far. I must have said as much because he smiled and said we were only alive because of people like me, people who caught details he missed and challenged his optimism. He said my cynicism made his optimism more real. I'm laughing again just thinking about it. Of all things to be worried about, he's worried about having hope, and he thinks I'm keeping us alive? God, what a man. 12th of August, 1969. Had another Root dream last night. This one was different, real. They were waiting for us, in my dream, near the hotel courtyard where we've been growing food. I told Ford about it. I thought he'd dismiss it. God knows my CEO did that often enough, but he said it was worth checking out. Good thing, too, because they were there, waiting. We fought them off because of my dream. Afterward, I admitted my other dreams to Ford, said it had been going on for a while. He wanted to tell the others, so I told the rest of the seven. We'll see what happens, but I think it was the right call. He's a good man, Andrew. I always knew it, but he's a good man. 15th of August, 1969. Okay, but what would it even look like if I hit on the leader of the ward? He doesn't need that right now. We're just trying to survive. Who the hell thinks of dating in a post-apocalyptic hellscope? Escape. 16th of August, 1969. Screw it. I'm asking him out. 17th of August, 1969. Well, hell. Turns out my feelings were mutual. Andrew didn't say anything because he was worried about what a relationship might do to leadership within the ward. Would it look like favoritism? Would it affect how the others saw me? What about when we argued? He started asking 1,000 questions. Until I shut him up. And I realized, as I was shutting him up, that this was the point. No matter how risky it might be, love is exactly what makes surviving worth the trouble. Besides, we have a goddamn common foe out there. It's not like we'll ever disagree on that. 1st of January, 1971. Holy hell, I forgot about this old thing. Guess you could say I've been distracted. Andrew and I got married last month, and today, I'm pregnant. I haven't told Andrew yet. I want to keep it to myself a little longer. It's hard to believe that there's a life inside me, a new person who didn't exist before. It was Andrew's idea. I thought he was crazy for even bringing it up. Who would raise a child on this creep show of an earth? Him and his damn optimism, but he's right. Children are the only future we have. I don't know what will happen to the little one, or hell, to us, but bringing a child into this world the Root are trying to rip away from us feels like rebellion. It feels like hope. And goddamn if that's not exactly what we need right now. Okay. That was quite the long. Oh, they took my sword. Oh shit, I broke a box. I'm sorry. Broke your box. I'm sorry. Can I break these boxes? Yeah. Ooh, money. How do I pick you up? Is it? Yep, it's E. Of course it's E. It's always E. I got scrap? What the fuck do I do with scrap? Okay, cool. I'm just breaking all you guys' shit. I hope you don't mind. What's over here? This is a fridge. Ooh, I can go in there too. Are you who I need to talk to? Yes, you are. Hello.
Well, well. Look who's awake.
Indeed.
You put up quite a fight outside our gates.
Who are you?
I'm Commander Ford. This is my base, and you, friend, are an unexpected guest. It's my job to know the kind of people I bring into Ward 13.
Yeah, okay.
We haven't seen a living soul on that shore for weeks. You will tell me why you were really out there, or we'll let the root have you.
Yeah, maybe you can help me. I'm trying to get to the island tower across the water.
No one has been in that tower in a very long time, but you've got no chance of getting there in this storm.
Okay, that makes sense.
The ward has been cut off.
Has it?
We had to block the gates after we dragged you in. The root are everywhere. But now that you're here, I have an idea. I'll tell you what. You want to leave? You'll have to do something for us first.
Yeah, all right. I mean, you did kind of pull me out of the...
First, we need power. That storm knocked out our reactor recently. With enough power, we might be able to activate another way out of here.
Okay, where's
the reactor?
The reactor
is on the lower basement level. There's a stairwell that leads down to it. Get it running, then come back here.
Why, trust me.
Because I'm not losing any more of my people today. We already lost a man down there a few days ago. I suspect the root have found a way in.
That makes
sense.
Go
check in with Riggs about your blade. I don't imagine your fists will do much against the root.
All right.
You do this for us, and I'll make sure you get out of here.
That seems like a fair trade. Mind if I beat up all your stuff? Wonder what all the scrap does. I'm sure there's a good reason for it. Can I break your computer? No. I like how I just punch the shit out of things. Wow. No scrap here? Okay.
Just through that door and down the stairs.
Alright.
Wits about you.
I certainly will as soon as I find more stuff to break. Oh, I'm out of stamina. Oh, no, I'm not. I just don't know how to press buttons. Hey, you've got my blade in here?
Keep walking, stranger.
Okay, I just wanted to say hi. Are you who I'm supposed to talk to? There we go.
Hey, it's good to see you on your feet again. Welcome to Ward 13. I did what I could to patch you up. You seem like a tough one, though.
Why, thank you.
Name's Rigler. Most everyone calls me Riggs.
Hello, Riggs.
Well, your sword was pretty banged up in the fight. Not much I could do with it, I'm afraid.
Okay.
The blade was shattered when we found you. Mostly scrap metal at this point. I think I remember Ace mentioned she found a few weapons out in the city. Maybe she'll help you out.
But my sword.
Last I heard, Ace went down to check out the reactor.
Of course.
Good luck down there.
OK. Can I just make a new one out of the shit I found?
Hope we get our power back soon. We can't get much done without it.
Can't I just make a new one? I found so much scrap. Alright, let's go look around here and then I'll go see about my sword. Oops, wrong way. I want to check this out over here first and talk to everybody. It's kind of important to me that I talk to everyone that I can.
Got out a backup plan. When the bullets run out.
Yeah.
Someone say Rudy getting in? Don't help the world in the dark. Can't see him coming.
Sometimes I wonder what life must have been like before all this.
Will you talk to me?
Honestly, I find it hard to sleep if I don't hear weeds screaming outside the door.
I mean, yeah, once you get used to it. Oh, I scared the kid. Sorry, kid. You're Wallace, right? Can I talk
to you?
See you
around.
Yep, okay. What about you? Will you talk to me?
Ford keeps us in the dark, figuratively and literally.
I'm sure it's for your own good. Wait, come back.
I hope you can restore the power soon, stranger. Without light and heat, our weakest won't last long.
Hey, hello.
I got my eye on you. Don't try nothing.
I just wanted to say hi. Okay. I guess I'm gonna go talk to the woman about the reactor. Because nobody wants to say hi around here. It's like some science room. Alright. What's that? Okay. Alright, random woman who's down here looking for people. I'm here to help. Yeah, I'm here to help. I heard you may have my weapon.
What? Where the hell did you come from? You nearly scared the life out of me. No one else wandering around down here.
Did you not see me come in?
You're not from around here, are you?
No.
My name's Ace. Ace Cotterill? You?
But I'm looking for the reactor.
Well, you found it. Starting that relic could mean trouble, though. So, you ever start a reactor?
Oh.
Well, it makes a lot of noise, for starters. Lucky for you, just the press of a button on the terminal above us. Would have done it myself, but without knowing what might come sniffing around. The two of us, though, maybe we got a chance.
Okay. I don't have a weapon.
So I have an idea. You go upstairs and start the reactor. I'll help you kill whatever comes our way.
Sounds like a plan.
You probably need a weapon, huh? Let's see if I can find you something.
Select your archetype. What the hell? The hunter specializes in long-range combat armed with ultra-precise hunting rifle, sturdy repeater pistol, and versatile scrap sword. The hunter excels at taking out targets before they get close. Their mod, Hunter's Mark, marks enemies, allowing the hunter and their teammates to see targets through walls. It also increases critical. Ex-cultist. The ex-cultist specializes in mid-range combat and support. Armed with a powerful coach gun, sturdy repeater pistol, and deadly scrap hatchet, the ex-cultist controls the mid-range with excellent burst damage. Their mod, Mender's Aura, casts an area effect heal that gradually restores health for all teammates. The scrapper specializes in close-range combat and melee damage. Arms with the devastating shotgun and sturdy repeater pistol and massive scrap hammer, the scrapper is at their best when close to the enemy. Their mod, Hotshot, imbues their ammunition with fire, giving it a chance to set enemies on fire. I'm somewhere between the ex-cultist and the hunter. I kind of really like using a bow and arrow in like every game I play, because I just like shooting things from far off. So I think I'm going to go with the hunter, to be honest. As much as the cultist looks absolutely amazing, I think I have to go with the hunter. Yeah.
There. Well, that should improve our odds. Get up there and start the reactor.
Okay. There's a way I can computer just. Ooh. And I can equip mods to it. Oh, I've got an inventory. Where did all my scrap go? Oh, I guess that's what money is. How do I pull out my melee weapon? That's how I aim. Alright. Okay. This probably isn't going to do me any good without teammates, but this will be fine. Is there any scrap in here anywhere? No. Ooh, maybe. How do I... How do I equip my melee weapon? Wait, what are the controls? That's so tab. Options, controls. Combat. Melee is left mouse button. Shoot is also left mouse button. How do I switch between them? Scope is middle. If melee and shoot are both left mouse button, alt fire mode? F. Switch weapon is X. Okay. Do I have to? Oh, I see. I have to aim to shoot. Got it. Give me a minute to pick up the scrap, and we will talk. So I have to aim to shoot. That's how they have the difference going. I take it I need to be up here. Is there any boxes around? Give me a second. I'll come back to you. Is that a box? No, that's a radio. Boxes, boxes, got lots of boxes. I don't want to run around hitting boxes while I'm waiting for stuff to kill me, so I'm going to get them all now, and then I won't have to worry about it later. All right, let's go hit the button. This seems like a really bad idea. Unauthorized use of this terminal is prohibited. Refer to the operations protocol. Let's fucking do it. Initialize reactor, view vault logs. System running low, low threshold. Oil feedback detected. Erratic seismic. Oops, what'd that say? Did not mean to do that. Oh, no, that wasn't the one I meant to read again. And fluctuations in core store banks. Performance compromised. I know what I'm supposed to be doing, but I want to know what's going on. Defense research. There's a lot of seismic stuff down in defense research. I have a feeling that there's going to be something big down there. Emergency power systems activated. Initialize, run system tests. Ooh. Everything's failing. I guess it's because it's offline. Oh shit. How do I help you fight? Oh. Fuck off. Anything coming from that side? No, okay. How do I reload? Oh shit. stop. God damn it. It does not like melee attacks. Okay. This bullet's gonna... Anything else up here? Nope, I need to go down and help her. Hello. Ow. Rude. Whoa. Alright. Oh shit, am I dead? Oh, okay. I forgot I had a pistol. That would have made things a lot easier. Okay. Any of them drop money? You know, because plants carry money.
I'll make sure to give you the need some help out there discount.
Sounds good. I completely forgot I had a pistol. How do I reload? Hold on. Yep, it's R. She didn't actually use a bullet, of course she didn't. Okay. Well.
Great work with the reactor, friend. You make a good team.
Indeed. I take it I can't talk to you yet to buy things. Even though I really want to. And I have no health. This game is so awesome. I love it.
Sure is good to have some light around here.
Hello?
You're risking a lot for folks you don't know, stranger.
Yeah.
Yes. You're trying to get yourself to that little island, yeah?
Yep.
Word moves fast when there ain't many words left around here. Listen, friend, I know you don't know me from a can of paint, but I want to help.
Okay.
You got a feeling of destiny about you. You're going to save the world, ain't you?
I'm going to try.
That's the spirit. Here, I want you to have this. Not many people can keep the spirits out there in the world. An old friend told me this little bobble could keep you from death at bay, at least for a while. And if you're looking to buy other treasures for your travels, come see me.
Yes.
Ace has got her own space over there. Between us, we got all sorts of treasures.
Let's talk.
That stone there, free of charge. Take good care of it.
Why, thank you.
Oh, one more thing. Ellen, Commander Ford, she knows more about that island than she lets on.
Of course she does.
Ask her about the founder of Ward 13. She'll get you on your path.
Sounds good.
You picked a hell of a time to visit the ward, friend.
Dragon hearts can be used to replenish health. There are a limited number of uses before its power is depleted. Dragon heart charges are replenished after resting at a checkpoint or dying. Press Q to use a dragon heart. Oh, they're like Estus flasks.
Why don't you go talk to Ellen? Sure, she'll want to thank you herself.
Wait, hold on. There's a box here. All right, I'm good.
A while since I was in a fight like that.
Do you have something new to say?
I heard those roots screaming from here. You didn't leave any stragglers.
No, ma'am.
The storm was bad omen.
So glad we're not in the dark anymore.
Yay, I made people sort of kind of happy, but they're still going to be miserable because post-apocalyptic, right? That's how this works. Hey, Miss Ford, I killed you. killed some things for you. Please let me have things now.
Glad to see you got the reactor running.
Yep.
And I see Reggie gave you the dragon heart.
Yes.
He wouldn't part with an artifact that powerful without a good reason.
He thinks I have a destiny.
I imagine he said I could help you.
Yep.
Very well. Reggie may play the old fool, but his judgment is rarely off the mark. You've proven yourself reliable, stranger. I'm willing to help you get on your way.
I'll take what I can get.
I doubt you'll last long out there without help. Go see Riggs and McCabe downstairs. They'll fit you with better gear.
Woo!
Come see me afterwards.
Okay. Yeah. I get new shiny things. Da 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 da. Hey, Riggs. Hey, Riggs. Hi.
Hey, Hello. Friend. Thanks for getting the power back on.
You're welcome.
Ford mentioned we should help you get sorted for the city. As a thanks for getting us out of a bind.
Yes.
Maybe we can put your old blade to good use after all. Let me look.
Did you just give me a bunch of stuff? Upgrading guns and armor. Riggs can upgrade your guns and armor with materials found in the world or by defeating enemies. Upgrading your guns and armor is essential to keeping up with increasingly difficult enemies in the game. I would love to upgrade this, please. Wait, I need armor. Ooh, I can probably go find better armor before I upgrade this armor. But honestly, my health, I don't think I could take it. Let's just upgrade this. What does this do? Damage. I'll go ahead and upgrade you. Now I have 3. I can't upgrade you, you're max level already. Alright. R for advancing attributes. Oh. Ooh. Okay. Thank you.
Alright, hey, now that's better. Oh, and take this. It's not the strongest stuff, but more protection than what you've got.
Huh?
Ah, there you go. A bit sturdier. Every little bit counts out there.
I am terrifying. Good lord, I look like an angel of death.
It's true. We don't have much, but you did right by us. Best we do right by you.
That's very sweet.
If you need any weapon upgrades in the future, come see me.
Okay.
McCabe over there will help you out with the augments for your gear.
Awesome. I'll
but,
go talk to him.
Stick to business talk. You know, she's not much for chat beyond her work.
Okay. I'll talk to McCabe. McCabe! Look. Look how awesome I look. Talk to me. You are so cute.
You're the stray Ford was talking about. Said we should get you equipped for the city. Doesn't make sense to me. Giving away good parts for nothing. Apparently taking out a few root is enough for our commander, though.
Hey.
I'm gonna give my time to every stray who wanders in. And we're having words.
What else
I'm
are
McCabe.
You doing?
I'm the engineer. And you're a pain in my ass.
Hello.
I'm not some scrap peddler. Got it? I don't upgrade trash.
Got it.
All right, then. Let's see what we're dealing with here. From the look of that rifle, you're not getting close to the action. This'll keep those weeds in your sights. That's all you get for now. Get me more components and I'll make more. For a fee.
Sounds good.
Now get out of here. I'm tired of your yapping jaw.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Weapon mods. Weapon mods are used to augment the power of your ranged weapons. When equipped, a weapon generates mod power by inflicting damage on enemy targets. When the power meter is full, press F to activate the weapon mod. Some weapon mods activate immediately, others activate an alternative fire mode for that weapon, allowing you to shoot powerful projectiles with devastating effects. Weapon mods can be equipped by going into the inventory screen, selecting a ranged weapon, and hitting X to equip a weapon mod to that weapon. Alright. So, boop. Oh, either one can work. How do I... Oh. Marks all enemies within 40 meters for the caster and their allies. Critical hit chance against marked enemies increased by 15% last 60 seconds. Ooh. Fancy.
Move on, stranger.
Well, fine, rude.
Ah, you're all set, friend. The commander should help you get on your way now.
All right. Return to Commander Ford. Do, 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 do. Hello.
Good to see you more equipped. Riggs and McCabe do good work. I hope this will be enough to get you on your way. We can't leave by the gates now, but the founder, my grandfather, gave me this key years ago. He said we should only use it when there's no other choice. Well, we are out of choices. Considering you stuck your neck out for us, it seems fitting you do the honors. Take it.
Why, thank you.
There's a terminal downstairs in the main room. Use the key there.
Dalla.
With any luck, we can get the thing running.
Thanks.
Don't thank me just yet.
Why not?
You should be able to use that key on the terminal downstairs. Never tested it myself.
Okay. How do I get out? There we go. Wait, where do I rest? I want to rest. It said resting replenishes my heart. Can I rest at that bed I woke up in? Hello? I guess not. I mean, it was worth a shot. You mean this terminal here? This one. No? This one. Yeah, this looks important. Key to continue. And log. The wards on the atoll have been overrun. We used the crystal to escape, but I'm not sure those things can't use it too. I'm shutting it down, and just to be safe, I destroyed the connection between us and the atoll. Don't think I could sleep otherwise. I know other ways to travel between wards, but, well, I'm the only one alive now who has these codes. We should be safe for now. Okay. Attention residents of Ward 13, do not use the crystal unless absolutely necessary. The crystal attracts the root somehow. It is vital that Ward 13 remain hidden from their attention. Unless the root are pounding on the door or something, use a different way out. If the root are pounding on the door, try to find me in the office immediately. This seems like a bad idea. What about this? Oh boy. Alright. Seems like a horrible idea.
About it, but I never saw it working. This red eye might be our only door to the outside world now. You want to get out of here? This is your shot.
You mentioned the founder.
My grandfather was the commander before me. They called him the founder of Ward 13.
Okay.
He brought everyone to Ward 13 when the root first attacked. He was determined to learn where the root came from. He spent so much time out there, searching. And one day, he didn't come back. I never knew what happened to him.
Do you think he's still alive? That seems like a really silly question. She seems like she could be possibly a mother or a grandmother herself. Her grandfather still being alive would be quite the long shot. Like, I know this sounds mean, but he'd have to be in, like, his hundreds, and a lot of humans don't live that long. It's possible, but they usually don't, though there is magic in this society. But he's out there fighting other, it just doesn't seem possible. Sorry.
There's a room just outside the ward. All his notes, any hint of where he went, it's there.
Okay.
You want to reach the atoll. He may be the last one who knew how to get there. Listen, I know this has all been a bit rough for you. Been rough for everyone. But you came through for us. For that, I'm grateful. You're welcome back anytime.
Aw, thank you.
Good luck.
That means a lot. Is my, just realized, is my camera covering anything? It'd be really funny if it was. It'd suck, but it would be kind of funny. My sister is all joinable. It was the tutorial. Okay. I think that this is a great time to end this episode here. We seem to have gotten to a nice stopping point before we continue on with the story. I'm sorry about the lag. It's probably going to continue out through the whole game. My computer is kind of a potato. I can't help it. All I can do is get more RAM, and I can't afford it right now. Because RAM is expensive, if you guys didn't know that. So, thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you in the next episode of whatever I decide to make. Lunernight signing out. Bye!